Hello guys, this is the second part of the video series which we have uploaded yesterday, and in this part also we will be taking few more numericals on the second topic of calorimetry, which is very simple. So this is the second part of those three parts. Let we get started. I've repeated this slide over in this video because, as we have discussed in the last video also, the parameters are very, very important with their symbol and the SI unit. Once we are thoroughly well versed with the SI units, it becomes less difficult for us to judge what is the question and what actually they want to us to answer. Moving on, this is the type 2 questions. We will be taking 4 questions in this video. These are the 3 formula we are going to use. First formula, Q is equal to P into T, that says heat energy is the product of power and time. Small t here denotes time. We will be making use of each and every parameter in the SI unit. This is joule, this is watt, and this is second. Capital C and small c are two confusing parameters. That is why I have given capital C in a violet color and small c in yellow color. So throughout this video, we will be using this color combination for them. Capital C is the heat capacity, which is the ratio of the heat energy upon the change in temperature. Delta capital T denotes the change in temperature. We know change in temperature is same whether it is in degree Celsius or in Kelvin. Don't get confused. And small c is the specific heat capacity, which is the ratio of the heat capacity, that is the capital C calculated in this step, upon the mass, and mass should be in kg. Let us take question number 1 on this. We can see the question goes like this. 1 kg of water is contained in a 1.25 kilowatt kettle. That is so obvious, we are going to deal with such questions, so we are going to have the value of power directly given, or maybe the question can be calculate power. So this is the power value given, but this is not in SI unit. We will take care of that. Calculate the time taken for the temperature of water to raise from 25 degrees Celsius to its boiling point. That's nice. This is the first temperature, initial, final temperature 100 degrees Celsius. So this will fetch us the value of delta T. Specific heat capacity of water, specific word they have mentioned, that is what means they have given us the value of small c. Let us see how the data goes. The data is like this. 1 kg. Why is the requirement of converting this kg into gram? Because the value given here is in gram. Specific heat capacity of water is given in gram. So we have converted mass into gram. 1 kg is equivalent to 1000 grams, we all know. Power, as I said, 1.25 kilowatt is given. We can't go with this unit, we need to convert it into SI unit. We have multiplied with 1000 because we know 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watts. So 1.25 multiplied by 1000 will give us 1250. Initial temperature 25, final temperature 100, and small c, you can see here, once again we have used the yellow color, that goes for small c. Specific heat capacity value they have given 4.2 joule per gram per Kelvin. So out of this 5 parameters, everything is given. If we see the equation to be used first, I can say let us use the first equation, third equation. This will help us to find the value of this capital C, violet C. So as it goes, we have used that equation first. Small c is equal to capital C upon m, which clearly implies capital C will be small c into m. So small c value 4.2, m value 1000 multiplied, we got the answer as 4200 joule per Kelvin. And we know the SI unit for heat capacity is joule per Kelvin or joule per degree Celsius. So we have got this. Now having got C, delta T we already can calculate from these two values. So we can calculate the value of Q. So second equation we are going to use is this one. So capital C is equal to Q upon delta T. So Q is equal to C delta T. C value we have got in the previous step. Delta T we can calculate now, that is final minus initial, 100 minus 25, and on multiplication you are gonna get 315,000 joules. That is the value of heat energy. Having got heat energy, what was the question? The question is calculate the time. So time is in this equation. This has to be used at the last because now we have got the value of Q. Power value was already given to us. We can calculate time. So let us move on. Third equation to be used now, Q is equal to P into T. So T is equal to Q upon P, and on substituting the values, 315,000 upon P, which we have calculated 1250, we got this many seconds, 252 seconds. Is 252 seconds, so if you want to convert it in minutes, we can leave the answer as such, or if you want to make it in a proper way, what we have to do is we have to divide it by 60, because we know 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. We are going to get 4 minute and 12 seconds as the answer. So very simple, we could see that we are using these three equations simultaneously. Once, what makes it easy that if you jot down the data what is given to us and you know, remember the equations, it is very clear to understand ki what is given to us and what is the value they are asking. So this way we have solved it. Let us take one more problem out of this. Again, we could see we have the question number has changed, but the formula are intact. That means again, based on the same formula, we are taking it in another sum. An electric heater of power 600 watt, very nice, power value has been given, raises the temperature of 4 kg of the liquid, this is the mass of the substance given, from 10 degree to 15 degree. So T1 and T2, we can calculate delta T in 100 seconds, even time they have given. So power, time, delta T and mass, these are the 4 values given to us. Calculate heat capacity, that means the capital C, then specific heat capacity, that is the small c. So it is so obvious, once we calculate capital C, we can use this equation to use, we can use this equation to calculate small c. So first equation which we can use is this, that's so obvious. First of all, let us copy down the data. The data goes like this. Again, 4 kg mass ko humne 4000 gram mein convert kiya. Why? Because we are going to get the answer in terms of joule per gram per Kelvin and joule per Kelvin. So humne isko pehle hi gram mein convert kar liya. Power directly SI unit mein diya hai, 600 watt. Temperature 1, 10 degree. Temperature 2, 15 degree. And time is 100 seconds already given to us. So pehla equation ye use karte hain, that is Q is equal to P into T. Humne use kiya, direct mere substitution of values. P 600 time 100 seconds multiply kiya, we got 60,000 joules. Is 60,000 joules ko, the value of Q to be substituted in this equation. Delta T we already know, we are going to get capital C. So let us see. This we have used, C is equal to Q upon delta T. We got 60,000 upon delta T is 15 minus 10 will give you 5. 60,000 by 5 has given us 12,000 joule per degree Celsius. Isko hum joule per Kelvin bhi likh sakte hain, because we know change in temperature is same in degree Celsius as well as in Kelvin. This thing which the change in temperature is same, we have discussed in the first part of this video series also. People who have not gone through the first part, the link is given in the description. You should go and check that video too. Having got the capital C value, let us now proceed to calculate small c. So small c, that is the yellow C, is equal to capital C upon M. Capital C 12,000 upon M value, we have calculated 4,000. Now we have got the term called gram. So joule per gram per Kelvin, or we could have written joule per gram per degree Celsius. On calculation, the value is 3 joule per gram per Kelvin. So answer 1, heat capacity, is this answer. Subpart 2, specific heat capacity, is this answer. So both the answers we have got. Moving on to the next problem. Again, we are going to use the same set of formulae. The question goes as such. 0.5 kg of lemon squash as 30 degrees Celsius. So mass, initial temperature, is placed in a refrigerator which can remove heat at an average rate of 30 joule per second. Now this makes the question interesting. They have given us here joule per second. What is this? Joule per second is power. This you should know. So they have given us, so 30 joule per second or 30 watt is the value of power. Instead of watt, they have written at 30 joule per second. So this was the value of mass, this is initial temperature, this is power. How long will it take to cool the lemon squash? So how long will it take? That means what is but thing they are asking here. Long means that is they are talking about time, kitna duration lagega. So parameter small t is missing here. So how long will it take to cool the lemon squash to 5 degrees Celsius? So now this yet another value. Ye initial temperature tha 30 degrees Celsius, 5 degrees Celsius is the final temperature. Specific heat capacity, word specific hai, matlab ye yellow ki baat kar rahe hain, hame small c ka value de diya hai, 4000 joule per kg per Kelvin. And this is to be noted here, kg is given, so this value should be in kg only, no problem. Let us check out what data we capture here. सो डेटा में हमने चेक किया मास इज़ डायरेक्टली 4.5 kg. वी हैव नॉट कन्वर्टेड दैट मास इनटू ग्राम, सो ऑब्वियस. टेम्परेचर वन, द इनिशियल टेम्परेचर 30, पावर 30 जूल पर सेकेंड, दैट इज 30 वॉट. टेम्परेचर टू 5 डिग्री सेल्सियस, स्पेसिफिक हीट स्मॉल सी इज इक्वल टू 4200 जूल पर kg पर केल्विन. वैल्यूज़ को अगर देखें, हमारे पास पावर है, टाइम नहीं है, हीट भी नहीं है, तो इस इक्वेशन को तो यूज़ नहीं कर सकते. कैपिटल सी के लिए क्यू चाहिए, क्यू नहीं है तो कैपिटल सी भी नहीं निकाल सकते, तो वी शुड स्टार्ट विथ स्मॉल सी. सो लेट अस सी, स्मॉल सी इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल सी अपॉन एम. सो कैपिटल सी निकल गया हमारा, सी इंटू एम, स्मॉल सी इंटू एम. वी कैन सी कलर कोडिंग हैज़ बीन मैच्ड. स्मॉल सी का वैल्यू 4200, एम इज 0.5 मल्टीप्लाई किया, वी गॉट द यूनिट एज जूल पर केल्विन एंड द आंसर इज 2100 जूल पर केल्विन. Having calculated capital C, we are in a position to multiply this with delta T. We will get the value of Q. Let us see. So, C is equal to Q by T. Q is equal to capital C delta T. Capital C value we have captured from here, 2100. Delta T is, what is that? 30 minus 5. So, 30 minus 5. Once you multiply this value, you're gonna get 52,500 joule. That is your heat energy, capital Q. कैपिटल क्यू वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड, हमें टाइम निकालना है, पावर हमें दिया हुआ है, तो क्यू बाई पी करने पे वी विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ टाइम. दैट इज़ द थर्ड यूसेज ऑफ द फॉर्मूला, क्यू इक्वल टू पी टी और टी इज इक्वल टू क्यू बाई पी. सो 52,500 द वैल्यू वी हैव ऑब्टेन इन द प्रीवियस स्टेप. पी 30 वॉट्स था, 30 वॉट्स हमने कैलकुलेट किया, वी गॉट 1750 सेकेंड्स. इसको हमने अगर मिनट में कन्वर्ट किया, डिवाइडेड बाई 60, यू गॉना गेट 29 मिनट 10 सेकेंड इज योर आंसर. सो वी कॉट सी कि एक ही सेट ऑफ फॉर्मूले पे और एक ही मेथड पे जस्ट मियर सब्सटीट्यूटिंग द वैल्यूज, फर्स्ट कॉपी डाउन द डेटा, अंडरस्टैंडिंग विच इक्वेशन टू बी यूज्ड फर्स्ट, एंड देन वी आर एबल टू क्रैक ऑल द क्वेश्चंस, ऑल द थ्री डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस. मूविंग टू द लास्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस वीडियो, दिस इज अगेन द सेम सेट ऑफ फॉर्मूला, क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 फॉर आवर वीडियो सीरीज. लेट अस सी हाउ द क्वेश्चन गोज. एन इलेक्ट्रिक हीटर ऑफ पावर 1000 वॉट्स, नाइस, दे हैव गिवन अस द वैल्यू ऑफ पावर. Raises the temperature of 5 kg of liquid, so this is so obvious, it is the mass given, from 25 degrees Celsius to 31, initial and final temperature, in 2 minutes, the time they have given, but they have given the time in minutes. So, hume time minutes mein nahi chahiye, hume time seconds mein chahiye, so we will take care of this. Calculate heat capacity of the liquid. What is heat capacity? Capital C. And specific heat capacity of the liquid, small c. It is quite similar to the second problem which we have done. Let us see how the data goes. The data is 5 kg. Humne convert nahi kiya kyunki hum ab heat capacity aur specific heat capacity ka calculation kg ke saath karenge. So specific heat capacity jisme mass ka unit hoga, wahan pe hum joule per kg per kelvin ya joule per kg per degree celsius mein answer nikalenge. So this is 5 kg. Temperature 125, temperature 231. So you can see here, temperature 2 हमने 31 लिया है. Time 2 minutes को हमने then and there 120 seconds, because 2 into 60 seconds will give us 120 seconds. And power, as I said, we have taken already 1000 watts. So अगर इन values, इन formula को देखे और इन values को देखे, तो we can very well judge कि कौन सा formula हमें पहले use कर सकते हैं. हम directly यह formula पहले use कर सकते हैं, because power भी हमें पता है, time भी हमें पता है. So that is the first formula, Q is equal to P into T. So Q, that is P value is 1000 multiplied by T value 120 will give us 120,000 joules. Jab capital Q hamare paas aa gaya, hame usko sirf delta T se divide karna hai, we will get the value of capital C, that is the blue C or violet C you can say. So this formula to be used, C is equal to Q by delta T, Q value 120,000 divided by delta T is 31 minus 25, so 31 minus 25. So 31 minus 25 will give you 6. 120,000 divided by 6 will give you 20,000. Or the answer is joule per degree Celsius. Or hum joule per Kelvin bhi bol sakte the. Jab capital C hamare paas aa jayega, isko hum m se divide karenge, hamare paas small c aa jayega. So small c is equal to capital C upon m. It is 20,000 divided by m is 5 kg. Humne as such kg ko use kiya hai. So you can see hamara answer bhi kg mein aaya hai. So 20,000 divided by 5, where did we get this 20,000 from? In the previous step, we have calculated capital C. That value only we have substituted. Capital C 20,000 upon 5, it is 4,000 joule per kg per degree centigrade or joule per kg per Kelvin. So this shows कि हमने four different variety के problem लिए, maybe you can say three different variety के problem लिए, but हमारा set of formula बिल्कुल same था. इन formula को याद रखेंगे और data अगर हम अच्छे से capture कर पा रहे हैं, each and every question is easy to go. I'll finish off this video with this only. All the best guys, and thank you so much. Do like, subscribe, share. Thank you.